Congressman Guinta, one of the first things you did when you got to Washington was push out against the EPA and the federal government's mandate against communities along the Great Bay Estuary. They wanted to mandate these communities put together some wastewater facilities to improve improve the Great Bay. Improving the environment has been such a big deal for Republicans. Judd Gregg, Charlie Bass, even Bob Smith. Why did you make the decision to vote to push against the EPA in this decision?
Yeah, we worked on that bill immediately after I actually cut my budget by 11.4%, froze congressional pay, and then also repealed the Affordable Care Act because business owners were looking for that kind of leadership. Then I heard from the six contiguous communities around Great Bay who were begging and pleading for assistance against the EPA because of nitrogen levels and that effect on yieldgrass. Everyone believes in the contiguous communities and in the state of New Hampshire that we want to protect our environment, protect Great Bay. But what the EPA wanted was to go from a 20 milliliter per liter level down to 3. You know what that would have done to those communities? $250 million of immediate improvements in the wastewater treatment facilities without guaranteed science. University of New Hampshire has different science on this than DES here in the state of New Hampshire. So people like Mayor T.J. Jean, Democrat from Rochester, came to me and asked me if we would help. They have all said, all of these communities have all said, we want to protect the environment, but the EPA is going too far and we need your help.
Ms. Shea-Porter, you talk about science and you talk about the environment. So do you think it's appropriate that the EPA mandates to these local communities to pay for these treatment centers, likely increasing property taxes?
Well, we were working on a compromise. I mean, this didn't just happen, and I also met with those communities looking for that compromise. The other thing that we did was we put money in to help people with their wastewater. If you look up in North Conway and other places, you'll see that the government was actually helping to do that. But what we have here with my opponent is, just to give you an idea of his attacks on the EPA and attacks on clean air and clean water, which have earned him zeros from these organizations. They have things like Stop the War on Coal Act, which I call and Start the War on Lungs. He's been voting to allow more mercury. He's been voting to allow dirty air. He has taken it way beyond just compromising with the EPA. So I think it's a significant difference.
Before we get to